second. Investment in equity shares of a company. So how do we account for investment in equity shares? That is what we'll learn. First of all, can you identify various transactions related to investment in shares? If you are investing money in shares of a company, please imagine what are the transactions that may take place. We'll learn how to account for them. Over. Purchase of investment. Okay, list of. Purchase of investment, purchase of shares. Next. Okay, here we'll have some incidental expenses. Very good. That's it. Only purchase of shares you will have. Suppose they are current investments. Current investment means they have purchased the intention to sell them off within a period of 1 year. Sale of investments. How to deal with sale of investment? How to deal with profit or loss on sale of investments? How will you decide profit or loss? Sale price minus cost price of the investment, you will get profit or loss. Dividends, yes, very good. Dividends, we can break it up into two parts. Pre-acquisition dividend. Post-acquisition dividend. What do you mean by pre-acquisition dividend? What do you mean by post-acquisition dividend? You have purchased shares in a company. Suppose, what is today? Today is 28th of October. You have purchased shares on 28th of October 2014. The company pays you some dividend. But dividends have been paid out of profits earned for the financial year 13-14. That means profits which were earned up to 31st March 14, out of those profits they have paid you dividends. When did you purchase the shares? You have purchased the shares today. What is today? 28th October. You are receiving dividends from the company. From what profits?
Last year.
From profits not earned out of your investment boss. Profits from the year 2013-14. Financial year 13-14. So profits are being declared out of dividends are being declared out of profits earned before you became the shareholder of the company. So these dividends are called as what? Pre-acquisition dividend. Pre-acquisition dividend. Before you acquired, the profits were earned. Out of those profits, dividends have been declared. Those dividends are called as what? Pre-acquisition dividend. What is the post-acquisition dividend? You have become the shareholder today, 28th October. Suppose you hold on to the investments. Up to 31st March 15, company earns some profits. Out of those profits, in the year, next year, that is in the financial year 15-16, they declare you some dividends. Now, dividends are declared out of profits which have been earned after you became shareholder of the company. Those dividends are called as what dividends? Is it clear? What is pre-acquisition dividend? You are receiving dividends. But dividends are coming out of profits earned before you became a shareholder. Those dividends are called as pre-acquisition dividend. Now what is post-acquisition dividend? You became a shareholder, you held on to your shares for some time, company earned some profits out of your investment, out of those profits company is declaring you some dividend. Those dividends are called as what dividend? Post-acquisition dividend. So how to deal with pre-acquisition dividend? How to deal with post-acquisition dividend? That is what we are going to learn in this chapter. Next. Anything else? Bonus shares. What do you mean by bonus shares? Shares declared for free. You need not send even a single rupee to the company. Company will send share certificates to your home, or the company will credit your DMAT account with free shares. Suddenly, yesterday I had 400 shares in DISCO in my DMAT account. Next day morning I wake up and I open my DMAT account and see 800 shares there. I see an entry, bonus shares received from the company, DISCO Limited, 400 shares. Then you check your bank account. Has anything been debited from my bank account? The answer is no. Nothing has been debited to your bank account, but you have received a credit in your DMAT account. Number of shares in your hand has increased, doubled overnight. Have received the shares for free. How to deal with bonus shares? Bonus shares. Your, what is the cost of acquisition of bonus shares? Can you tell me?
Zero.
So only number of shares will change, but you have not incurred even a single rupee out of your pocket. So you will say cost of these shares will be zero. After that, bonus shares?
Right shares.
Right shares, very good. Not sweat equity shares, boss. Sweat equity shares can be allotted only to
employees,
directors who are putting in their hard work for the company apart from investment. So, if you are an investor, you cannot ask for sweat equity shares. You cannot say, my hard earned money I have invested, hence you have to give me sweat equity shares. Then every shareholder will say, my hard earned money, give me sweat equity shares. It is not possible. I think Companies Act has strict provisions for allotment of sweat equity shares also, because sweat equity shares are normally held at a discount. Okay. So now how to deal with all these things, that is what we are going to discuss. Start writing now. Now what are right shares before we continue? What are right shares? Old Companies Act 1956, section 81, pre-emption rights, talks about rights issue. So a company, if it wants to increase the capital, if the board of directors want additional capital to take up, to carry on the business of the company, according to section 81, they have to approach the shareholders first. Give them an opportunity to subscribe to the fresh capital being issued by the company. And they have to give the shareholders an opportunity to maintain their shareholding. If the shareholders are not ready to invest money, then the board is authorized to issue shares to outsiders and raise the money from outsiders. That is called as rights issue. These are not shares issued for free, boss. You are selling the shares to the shareholders. And normally what we'll do is, to motivate the shareholders to invest money in the company, we'll offer the shares at a discount when compared to the market price. Suppose the market price of the share is 500 rupees. We want our shareholders to invest additional capital for our new businesses, for our new projects. We can tell the shareholder, market price 500. If you buy from us, we'll give it to you for 475. Take 25 rupees as discount. Buy today for 500. Buy today for 475. Tomorrow you can sell it for 500, making a neat profit of 25 rupees per share. Shareholders will jump for it. Why? Even if I take borrow money from a bank and buy these shares, no, it is not a loss for me. Why? I can buy the share for 475 today. As soon as the shares are allotted to me, I can sell it for 500 or more. If the price increases further, within a week's time or within a month's time, I will get 25 rupees income. Profit. Are you able to understand? So shareholders may go and buy the shares. Or I think section 81 talks about it. Shareholders have the right to renounce their rights. Now, normally what will happen? Company will send a rights offer letter to the shareholder. In that offer letter, it will be mentioned how many shares the shareholder is entitled to buy, at what price. Letter will be sent by the company to the shareholder. Now, the shareholder has two options. One, fill up that letter, fill in the blanks, write how many number of shares he wants to buy, send money to the company and get the shares allotted. Or take this letter, go to the market. If somebody is interested, sell that letter, take some money and forget about the rights. So either you may exercise the rights and buy the shares, or you may renounce it in the market and get some money out of selling the rights letter in the market. Sir, why will somebody buy the letter in the market? So the benefit from one letter is, one share is 25 rupees, So if they say 15 rupees you take, 10 rupees still I enjoy. If I go and purchase the share in the market, it's available for 500. But if I purchase through this letter, it's available only for 475. So they'll say, shareholder, you are not interested, no? Take 15 rupees, forget about the right, give it to me, I'll purchase it from the company. I'll still get a benefit of 10 rupees. Is it clear? So, right shares, the company will send rights letters to the shareholders. The shareholder have two options. One, renounce the right in favor of somebody else, take some money for renouncing, or subscribe for the shares on your own. If they keep quiet, what will happen? They don't exercise any option. Option to buy or option to renounce. Then what will happen? The board of directors, according to their discretion, they can dispose of those shares. Which is the discretion of the board of directors to dispose of those shares. They will find somebody and sell the shares to anybody. So that is, we can say, the authority of the board of directors. Now we have to learn how to account for all these things. Start. Right now. Entries when shares are purchased. When shares are purchased. When shares are purchased. And incidental expenses are incurred. And incidental expenses are incurred. That means you have paid some brokerage, securities transaction tax, stamp duty, you have incurred some amount. What is the entry you write when you purchase shares? Shares. They are an asset for you. Real account coming in, debit. You are paying money through your bank account, personal account, giver, credit. Write down the entry. Entry will be investment in shares account retar. Write like this. Investment in shares of ABC Company Limited account retar. Investment in shares of ABC Company Limited account retar. To bank account. Below this, below the entry you'll write, the entry will be passed with the purchase price plus incidental expenses. The entry will be passed with the purchase price plus incidental expenses. Second transaction. Sale of investments. Sale of shares. When shares are sold. Write down. What is it you write? Bank account debtor to investment in shares of ABC Limited account. Bank account debtor to investment in shares of ABC Limited account. So which account will be credited now? Same investment account will be credited. Below that entry you'll write. Entry will be passed with the net sale proceeds. The entry will be passed with the net sale proceeds. Then you will write, what do you mean net sale proceeds? Sale price minus incidental expenses, if any. Sale price minus incidental expenses, if any. Now what is this incidental expenses? I told you, when you want to sell shares in the stock market, you have to sell it through a broker. Now, suppose brokers charges 0.5% as commission. 0.5% of the sale price as commission. Now, just take a calculator. Suppose the value of the share is 1000. You have sold the share for 1000. Please tell me how much will you get net? you are selling the share in the stock market for a sale price of 1000, broker is going to charge 0.5% as commission. So net how much will I get? 1000 minus 0.5%. How much is it get? So you get 995 rupees net. So this net amount has to be shown as income in your books. You cannot show gross amount and then show expense in the P&L account. You cannot show gross 1000 and show 5 rupees as expense. You have to show 1000 minus 5, 995 as your income. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Next. Now, you have purchased, you have sold. So definitely you have to talk about
profit
or loss on sale of investment. Right now. Profit or loss on sale of investment. Underline.
Anything, accounting will be same. Only valuation rules will change. Accounting for any investment, current and non-current will be same.
Right on. Profit or loss on sale of investment. Below that you write A. When there is profit on sale. Not only profit on sale should be credited to which account? Profit and loss account. Debited to which account? Investment account. Now, listen to me carefully. Investment purchased for 10,000. Debited with 10,000. Sold for 12,000. Credited with 12,000. How will you close the account? Once investment is sold, the asset account has to be closed, boss. Unless the asset is there, you cannot show the account. Till the day asset is there, you can show the account. Once the asset is not there, you have to close the account. Debited with 10,000, credited with 12,000. This account is not getting closed. How will you close it? Debit the account and give a credit to the profit and write on the entry. What is entry? The investment in shares of ABC Limited account returned to profit and loss account. Investment in shares of ABC Limited account returned to profit and loss account. Now, how to calculate profit or loss? We'll do that later. Write on next. B. When there is a loss. When there is a loss. Please tell me what is entry will pass when there is a loss. Loss means purchase for 10,000. Investment account was debited with 10,000. Sold for 9,000. Debited 10,000, credited 9,000. The asset is not there. Account has to be closed. Debit 10, credit 9. There is a balance of 1,000. Account has to be closed. How will you close it?
Credit.
Transfer that balance to the profit and loss account. Give a credit to the investment account. Give a debit to the profit and loss account. So what is it to write? Profit and loss account at R2 investment in the shares of ABC Limited account. But in your P&L account, you will not say 2 investment in shares of ABC Limited account. You will say 2 loss on sale of investment. How much? 1000 rupees. Or you can say with the loss amount. With the loss amount. This entry will be passed with the loss amount. Now write down how to calculate profit or loss on sale of investment. Please tell me, what is the general rule you have learned to calculate profit or loss on sale of assets? Sale price minus WDV. This is not a depreciable asset. So you say sale price minus cost price. How do you ascertain cost? If the shares, listen to me. If the shares are purchased in batches, shares of ABC Limited, 1st January you have purchased some, 1st February you have purchased some, 1st April you have purchased some, during the year you have received some bonus shares, during the year you have purchased some right shares. You have purchased the shares not in one batch. You have purchased the shares in many lots. And you have also received some shares through bonus shares. You also received some shares through right shares. In such a case, you have to go for average cost basis. What basis?
Average cost.
Right on. Profit or loss is equal to sale proceeds, net sale proceeds minus average cost of shares sold. average cost of shares sold. So we have to determine the cost of shares sold on an average basis. Is it clear, everyone? So how will we determine the cost price of the shares sold on an average basis? How will you do it? When we solve problems, you will come to understand. Now, if sale proceeds are more than average cost, profit. If sale proceeds are less than average cost, loss. Write down that also. If sale proceeds are greater than average cost, profit. If sale proceeds are less than average cost, you will have a loss. Next slide down. Treatment of dividends. Right down. When post-acquisition dividend is received, when post-acquisition dividend is received, you pass the entry bank account data to dividend income account. Bank account data to dividend income account. Very simple treatment. So when you receive post acquisition dividend, what is the post acquisition dividend? The dividends are being declared by the investee company. We are investors. The company in which we have invested money is called as the investee company. The investee company is declaring dividends out of profits earned after we have invested money in the shares of the company. In such a case, it is called as post-acquisition dividend. Simple treatment, credited to profit and loss account. Credited to profit and loss account. So you have not said credited to profit and loss account. I have credited which account? Dividend income account. Dividend income account in the future will be transferred to profit and loss account of the investor. Is it clear? B. When pre-acquisition dividend is received, when pre-acquisition dividend is received, what is the pre-acquisition dividend first of all?
Dividend means profit.
Same example, remember that. October 28, you purchase shares in a company. Next day, you receive a check for dividend. You are stunned. Yesterday I have purchased shares, today I have received a check.
What a company.
When you make an inquiry, you come to know that the dividends were declared out of profits earned in the year 13-14. Then you start thinking, 13-14, was I a shareholder? No. The other guy, the guy who sold me the shares, he was the shareholder in the company. So the dividends are being declared out of profits earned before you became a shareholder. Such dividends are called as pre-acquisition dividends. Accounting standard 13 requires you to reduce this income from the cost of investments purchased. Write down. Entry. Before you write the entry, write. It should be reduced from the cost of shares purchased. It cannot be credited to profit and loss account. It should be reduced from cost of shares purchased. It should not be credited to P&L account. We don't treat it as a revenue receipt, we treat it as a capital receipt. Write down entry. Entry will be bank account debtor to investment account. Bank account debtor to investment in shares of ABC Limited account. Bank account debit are two investments in shares of ABC Limited account. So which account is credited? Investment account, not the dividend income account. Why? What is the logic? Why am I reducing the cost?
For
it is to be reduced from cost?
Because we didn't reserve this profit.
Okay, I'll give you a small example to understand this concept. It's not about shares, but to tell you the meaning. There's a building standing. Okay. Seller wants to sell the building. You are the buyer. You want to buy this building. Okay, listen to me carefully. The deal happens on 30th June 2014. Okay. The seller has given this building on rent to Infosys. Infosys pays rent once in 6 months. The rent of the building for 6 months is 10 lakhs. For 6 months, rent will be paid once in 6 months, not every month. Because they will say, you please don't come to me every month. Once in 6 months, we'll send you a check, you enjoy. Not prepaid, postpaid. If it is prepaid, no, then the landlord will be very happy. So, rent from 1st January to 30th June will be paid on 30th June. Okay, suppose, let's change it. 29th June, the deal is taking place. This building, seller wants to sell to a buyer. On this, the seller has already given this building on lease to Infosys, and the rent is 10 lakhs for 6 months. Okay. Now, suppose the building has about 1000 square feet of place. Only 1000 square feet. For the sake of removing confusion or for the sake of reducing the numbers. Suppose the building has how much space in it? 1000 square feet. I want to sell. I want to sell the building at 4000 rupees per square feet. In the surrounding area, the buildings are sold at a rate of how much? 4000 per square feet. You have a building with how much space in it? 1000 square feet space in it. The prevailing market price in that area is 4000 rupees per square feet. So how much do you expect by selling the building? How much do you expect to get by selling the building?
40 lakhs.
Express 1000 into 4000, 40 lakhs. Okay. Now, my question is, will the seller sell the building to the buyer for 40 lakhs? Varshit is saying 50. Will you agree with him?
Yes.
Why? Because this 40 lakh is only the value of the building. What about the accrued income? There is some accrued income. From where accrued income has come, sir? 1st January to 29th June. You are only 1 day away from receiving 6 months interest loss. Not interest, rent. You are 1 day away from getting rent. But you are not able to stop yourself. You want to sell away the building. I would understand. So if I wait for 1 day, I'll get my 10 lakh rupees rental income. On 1st July, if I sell for 40 lakhs, no, I'll be considered as an intelligent man. If 29th June, if I sell the building for 40 lakhs, and the buyer receives that rent of 10 lakh from Infosys, I'll be considered as a fool. Not normal fool. Fool Gobi, they say, no? So you consider as a full Gobi. So now we assume, he said, both seller and buyer are knowledgeable parties, no? Seller will say, they take calculator, okay? 1000 square feet into 4000, 40 lakhs price of building. 6 6 months interest, not interest, right? Already earned. I am selling away the building on 29th June, but already 6 months rent is earned. So plus 10 lakh. You'll say 50 lakhs. Take it or leave it. Now, will the buyer buy it?
Yes.
Now, seller has offered the building to the buyer for how much? 50 lakhs. Now, buyer will make calculations. Okay. 50 lakhs is saying. Okay. Same building available in the market, 1000 square feet, at the rate of 4000 square feet, at the rate of 4000 per square feet, 40 lakhs only. Then you will think, why is this guy asking 50 lakhs instead of 40 lakhs? He'll ask the seller, why are you, then he will go and inspect the building. He comes to know that Infosys is, has taken that building for rent and the seller is getting 10 lakh rupees for 6 months as rent. He knows that this 50 lakh is loaded with accrued income. Accrued income how much?
10
lakh. So buyer, if he pays 50 lakhs, please tell me, what is the cost of actually purchasing the building for him? This is segregated boss, I have paid 50 lakhs, but I know out of that only 40 lakh is paid for building, remaining 10 lakh is paid for accrued rent. Now my question is, suppose buyer has paid 50 lakhs and purchased the building, who will receive the rent now? On 1st July, deal happens on 29 June itself. 29 June, he will give half paid, half poker to the seller, buyer. Take half poker, go away. 29 June, get out. He gets the documents also registered on the same day. 1st July, Infosys will write a check. They will send the check to whom?
Buyer.
So now, I have paid 50 lakhs on 29 June to purchase the building. On 1st July, I receive a neat check of 10 lakh for rent.
Okay,
now can I say the cost of my building is 50 lakh and this 10 lakh is my income? So you have two options, boss. In the books of buyer, two options are there. One, show the building as 50 lakhs in your books and show 10 lakh as rental income in your books. Now, is it correct this accounting? Why no? Boss, you have held on to the building only for 2 days. Can you say 10 lakh is my income for 2 days? Is it reasonable? Matching periodicity, some concepts which you have learned, fundamental concepts. This 10 lakh, so one option is show building 50 lakhs in as an asset in your balance sheet, show 10 lakh as an income in your profit and loss account. Or other option is show building 50 lakh minus accrued rental income received 10 lakh, you will show net amount 40 lakhs in your balance sheet as the cost price of purchasing building. Which accounting treatment are you in favor of? Second or first?
Second.
I am not in favor of the first treatment because you are double counting something. You are showing the building at a value higher than its real value in the market and you are showing income which you have not earned. You have not earned that income, hence you cannot show that income. So what you should do is, even though buyer pays 50 lakhs for purchasing the building, when he receives the rent, he has to subtract the rent from the building value and he has to show the building at the net cost. Similarly, in the case of shares, in place of building, we can put shares. This 10 lakh is the amount of dividend which he is about to receive from Infosys. This is the rate at which he wanted to sell the share, only the share. But he knows that he is going to get receive some dividends from the company. In such a case, he will sell the share to the seller, to the buyer, for 50 lakhs. Buyer also knows, if the share is available in the market without dividends, it is available for 40 lakhs. But I am paying extra 10 lakh towards dividend which is going to come in the future. Is it clear? Are you able to understand? So the buyer, even though he has paid 50 lakh, he will segregate. 40 lakh was paid to building, 10 lakh was for dividend. So as soon as I receive dividend, remove that 10 lakh from the cost of the building and show building at the real cost. Is it clear? That is why we credit the pre-acquisition dividend to which account? To the investment account. Right on, next. You want one more example?
No, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell that, but off the camera. Right on, next. So, pre-acquisition dividend, what is the rule, right? Bank account, data to investment in shares of ABC Limited account. You have to reduce it from cost of the investment. How do you identify whether a dividend is pre or post? You have to find out from which profits are the dividends declared. The dividends are declared out of profits earned after you have become shareholder, post acquisition. If the dividends are declared out of profits earned after you have become shareholders, they are called as?
Post.
After you have become shareholders, if profits have been earned, out of that dividend is declared post. If the dividends are declared out of profits before you became shareholder, then pre-acquisition dividend. Pre-acquisition dividend reduced from past of investment of share. Post-acquisition dividend credited to your profit and loss account. So it has an income. Next, write down. Bonus shares. Problem solving is very, very simple. Bonus shares. Right on. Bonus shares are shares received for free. Bonus shares are shares received for free. Entry. Entry. No entry. No entry. No entry. What will you write? No entry. What will you write below that? No entry will pass, but number of shares would be increased. Number of shares would be increased. Bonus shares will reduce your average cost. Sir, how will it reduce our average cost?
How, sir? Fukat mein, sir.
Don't want?
Very no, sir, don't want. Sir, don't want, sir.
Sir, come, sir. Both categories of people in this class. Very difficult for me. 1,000 shares, you purchase for 1,000 rupees each. You have spent 10 lakhs. You receive bonus shares, 1,000 shares at the rate of 0. Cost is 0. 1,000 shares purchased at the rate of 1,000, 10 lakh cost. 1,000 shares received for free at the rate of 0, 0 rupees. So total cost is 10 lakh. Total number of shares is 2,000. Average cost is 10 lakh divided by 2,000. 500 rupees per share. So because of bonus shares, average cost per share will reduce. Continue. Next. Rights share. Rights share. Write down. When rights shares are subscribed, listen to me carefully. You are holding shares in a company for last 1 year or last 2 years. Company sends you a rights letter. You fill up the letter, you attach a check, send the check in the letter to the company, shares are allotted to you. You are buying rights shares. What is entry you write? Write down. Investment in shares of ABC Limited account at R2 bank account. Same entry. You are now buying the share not from outsider, from the company itself. Investment in shares of ABC Limited account at R2 bank account. Now here, listen to me carefully. Suppose you are not the shareholder. You are not the shareholder of the company. You go to the market, you buy the letter from the market, and then you fill up the letter and purchase shares in the company. Then same entry will pass, but the cost will be different, boss. You have to pay 475 rupees to the company for buying the right shares. Plus you would have paid something for buying that letter also in the market, no? Remember the example, yes, 500 rupees share market price, company is offering for 475. You are not shareholder, you have not received letter from the company. So you go to the market to find a shareholder renouncing the right. A shareholder is not interested in buying the, we can say, the rights letter, the right shares. So he is selling the shares. You go to the market and say, you are the shareholder of that company, no, you have a rights letter, please give the letter to me. I'll give you 10 rupees per share. So he gives you the right letter. You fill up the rights letter, you send it to the company, company allots you the share at 475. You have paid 475 to the company to get the shares, plus you have paid 10 rupees to the shareholder who has renounced the right in your favor. Same entry will pass, but with a different amount. So whatever amount you have paid to acquire the letter, that should also be added to the cost of the investment. Write down below that. Below the entry, you'll write. If right shares are subscribed by purchasing the letter in the market, cost of buying the letter should be added to the cost of the shares subscribed. The cost of buying the letter should be added to the cost of buying the shares. If you are the shareholder, you receive letter, you subscribe, then letter has come for free to you, no boss. You cannot add any cost for the letter in the market, again to the cost of the shares. Is it clear? Are you able to understand? Next. Right on. When rights letter is sold in the market, I told you have two options when you receive a letter from the company. One, buy shares that you already know. If you don't want, offload the letter in the market, sell off the letter in the market. Right on. When rights letter is renounced or sold in the market. Below that you underline, right, situation A. If please put 5 stars, 10 stars, 100 stars to this particular point, very, very, very important and the most confusing area in accounting for shares. If rights letter was received because of shares held for a long period of time, what does that mean? I have been holding on to the shares for the last 3, 4, 5 years. I have been holding on to the shares. Now company, because of my, we can say, sincerity, and I have been investing money in the company, I have kept my investment in the company for a long period of time. Company feels it is better we give our shareholder some benefit. So they send me a rights letter. Right on. If rights letter is renounced, entry. If rights letter is renounced, entry. Bank account data to P&L account. Bank account, debtor to P&L account. So whatever income I get by selling the right shares, the letter, it should be credited to the profit and loss account. Write down below that. The amount received from sale of letter should be credited to P&L account. The amount received from sale of letter should be credited to profit and loss account. Right on, next, situation B. Right on. the rights letter was received, because of shares purchased recently, this rights letter was received because of shares purchased recently. Cum rights purchase. And the letter is sold in the market. Full stop, continue. The amount received from sale of the right, should be credited to
investment.
The investment account to the extent of decline in the value of shares after they become ex-right. Sold right, the amount received from sale of the rights should be credited to the investment account to the extent of decline in the value of shares after they become ex-right. Entry. I'll tell you what is the meaning. Entry. Bank account debtor to investments in shares of ABC Limited account. Bank account or to investment in shares of ABC Limited account. This treatment has to be provided when, read the situation again. Recently you have purchased some shares on a cum rights purchase and you receive rights letter from the company and you sell the rights letter in the market. You get some money out of it. You get some income. So how do you deal with it? It should be credited to investment account. But to what extent? To the extent of decline in the value of the shares once they have become ex-right. What does that mean? Look at the board, everyone. Suppose the board of directors meeting where the rights issue is decided happens on 1st September 2014. On 1st September 2014, board of directors meeting took place in a company called as ABC Limited. The board meeting was called for deciding what? Issue of rights shares to the shareholders. On 1st September, the board decided that for every share held by a shareholder, they will be given a right to buy one more share in the company. but at a discount. Discount when compared to the market price. Board meeting took place on 1st September. The same day they have to send a copy of the resolution passed to the stock exchange. That means this information will become public on that day. On the date itself, it will become public. Public will come to know that company is about to declare right shares. Now, the company has a confusion now. To which shareholder should I give this option? They want a list of shareholders to whom they have to send the letters. Company announces a record date. 30th September 2014. They announce it as a record date. What is a record date? So the company will say, boss, shareholders who are holding shares on 30th September, to them we will send the rights letter. When they decide? 1st September. In that board meeting itself, they have decided to record it also and they will announce it. What is the significance of this date was? The date is very significant because on this date, whoever appears as a member in the register of members of the company, to his home you have received the rights letter. To his address, the company will send the rights letter. What is this gap for? If anybody has purchased or sold shares during this period, he has to submit the transfer document before 30th September so that the list of members can be updated. You can remove the names of the sellers, include the name of the buyer. So if you have purchased or sold shares during this period, you have to submit your documents before 30th September to the company so that the company will remove the names of the seller and include the name of the buyer. Is it clear? Just listen to me. Suppose the share market price of the share was 500 rupees in the market before the board meeting took place. The board has decided to offer the shares to the shareholders for 475. Offer the shares to the shareholders for what? 475. Now what will happen is, every shareholder knows that if I am holding one share, I am going to get a benefit of 25 rupees per share. Now what will happen is, the market price of the share will increase now during this period. Because we know that every share, if you sell in the market, you get 500. But because of a new offer called as the rights offer, every shareholder is going to get a benefit of 25 rupees. Nobody will sell their share in the market for 500 rupees now. Why? If I sell for 500, the buyer will get a benefit, boss. He will buy the share for 500 rupees and in the future he will get a rights letter. He can sell it in the market and he will get some benefit out of it also. That means he will get the shares at a discount in the market. So during this period, the market value of the share is expected to go up. Is it clear? Now, during this period, listen to me carefully. During this period, you go and purchase the share in the market for 5-10 rupees. You have gone to the market and purchased the share for how much rupees? 5-10 rupees. On 30th September, you are the shareholder now. Company sends you a rights letter. You, what can you do with this rights letter now? If you want, you can subscribe for fresh shares in the company and increase your shareholding, or you can sell away the letter in the stock market and get your income back, get your money back. You have purchased for how much now? 5-10. Now, after this day, the market value of the shares will come down again. Why? From this day, you don't have the benefit of the rights offer from the shares, because the shareholders who were holding the shares on 30th September, they will get all the rights offer. But after 30th September, if you buy the shares in the company, you are not going to get the letter. The old shareholders are going to get the letter. When you purchase the share, you purchase it for 510. Okay? Once the share, the record date is over, we will say the share has become X right. During this gap, we will say shares are traded cum right. During this gap, if you buy the shares, we will say we have gone for a cum rights purchase. After this date, if you purchase shares, they are called as X-rays. Why X-ray? What is the meaning of X? Excluding. That means if you buy the share after 30th September, will you get the rights letter, boss? No. That means you are buying the share, excluding the right. Who will get the right then? The shareholders who have sold the shares? The shareholders who have purchased the share before record date, they will get the shares cum right. But if you sell the share after, if you purchase the share after the record date, you are not going to get the share, the rights that are along with the share. So shares are traded in this gap, come rights, after this date, X rights. Is it clear? Forget about all these things. You have purchased the share for 510 rupees. You received a letter from the company. You sold the letter in the market and you received 20 rupees income out of it. You purchased the share for how much? 510. You have sold the letter in the market and have received an income of how much? 20 rupees. Now, after 30th September, the market price of the share falls down to 500 rupees. When you purchase the shares were being traded cum rights. So the shareholder you saw, who sold the shares to you, he said, boss, you are purchasing a share from me, you are going to get the benefit of receiving a letter from the company. So you give me 500 plus something extra. So you paid, okay, take 500, take 10 rupees. You purchase the share for 510. Okay. And because you have purchased it before the record date, I got the letter from the company. And then I sold the letter in the market. I got how much? 20 rupees. Now, after the record date, that is after 30th September, the market price again comes back to 500. Now see, there is a decline here. When you purchase for 510. But after record date, market value has reduced to 500. So this 20 rupees income which you have received, out of this 20, 10 rupees should be credited to investment account and 10 rupees should be credited to profit and loss account. Now, read that sentence which I gave you, very, very important. Look at the board. If I prepare investment account, I purchase the share for 510. Bank. I sold the letter for how much? 20. I know that after 30th September, the value of the share is not 510 anymore. It is only how much? 500. I am showing the asset at 510, but I know market value is only 500. When I sold the letter, I got an income of how much? 20 rupees. How to deal with this income? This is what I am talking about. What does the sentence say? Read that. The amount received from sale of letter should be credited to investment account. To what extent? To what extent should I credit to the investment account? To the extent of decline in the value of shares after it becomes X rights. Up to 30th September, cum rights, after that it has become X rights. Cum rights value was 510, X rights value is only 500. So there is some decline. How much decline? 10. How much do you receive as interest, as income from sale of rights? 20. Out of 20 rupees, to the extent of decline, you can credit it to the investment account. And remaining 10 rupees should be credited to profit and loss account. So here you pass an entry, bank account debtor 20 rupees, to investment account 10 rupees, to profit and loss account 10 rupees. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll write here buy bank, investment account, no? 10 rupees. But actually how much did I receive? 20. So where is the next 10 rupees credited? Profit and loss account. Suppose X right price is not 500, it is only 490, then? Then what will I do? I purchase it for 510. Before record date, I purchase it for 510. Come rights purchase. I knew that I am purchasing a share because of which I am going to get a right. I can either subscribe for the shares or I can sell the right in the market. I paid 510 to buy the share. But immediately after record date, I find that the value has reduced to 490. When I sell the letter in the market, I got how much rupees? 20 rupees. My question is, what will you do with this 20 rupees now? Read that sentence again. What does it say? Amount received from the sale of rights to the extent of decline in the value of shares. Once the shares have become X rights, have to be credited to the investment account only. So amount received from sale of rights to the extent of decline. What is the decline? 20 rupees. It should be credited to which account? Entire 20 rupees will be credited to the investment account. Entire 20 rupees will be credited to investment account. Is it clear? Did you understand? Dump rights was 5-10. X-side was also 5-10. Dump rights, that is before the record date, the shares are purchased for 5-10. After record date also there is no change in the market value of the share. It is at 5-10 only. You got 20 rupees from share of from the sale of shares. Right setter. Inside 20 rupees should be credited to profit and cost account. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So when you have received shares in a cum rights purchase transaction and you have received rights letter, you sell the rights letter in the market, the income which you get to the extent of decline in the value of shares once they become X right should be credited to investment account. Extra amount should be credited to profit and loss account. If there is no decline, entire amount should be credited to the profit and loss account. Write down that point also. If there is no decline, value more and then why did the value reduce? As soon as rights offer is announced, shareholder knows that boss, current market value is 500. But if somebody buys my share, he gets some additional benefit also, no? So he'll sell the share not at market price, he would charge some premium because he knows that the buyer is going to get a letter from the company. From that he's going to get some benefits. That is the price will increase. Why will price reduce? Because once the shares are X-right, that means the right is not attached to the share, then the real value comes into picture. Hence the value automatically reduces. Is it clear? You understand the point? So right, if there is no decline, entire amount should be credited to profit and loss account. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, in the solution which they have given in their textbook, they have always followed this method. They are not concerned whether the rights letter is received because of a cum rights purchase or because of holding shares for a long period of time. That distinction is not made. They are treating every, we can say, every problem or every transaction like this only. So whenever you sell a rights letter in the market, they are saying it is because of a recent purchase, cum rights purchase. So whatever income you are getting, credit it to investment account. Reduce it from cost of investment. Is it clear? When you see the problem, you'll understand what I'm talking about. Continue. Over, I think this is what we will discuss on right shares. Now, take one more situation. You buy rights, sell rights in the market. You are a dealer in letters. Buy letters, sell letters. Any profit or loss should be credited to profit and loss account. Nothing will be coming in the investment account. Okay, now we'll have a 10 minutes break and then we'll start solving problems. 10 minutes, what do you get?